Hello, and thank you for joining me, Shanny Leigh, for this arm recovery flow. In my last video, we focused on the lower body leg recovery, and now we will focus on the upper body. So this is perfect if you lift or just did something with your arms and you kind of just need to stretch it out, so not too much work. So thank you again for joining me, and I will see you on the mat. So we'll get started here today in Tadasana pose, mountain pose. So I invite you to find a nice standing position. If you really want to sit, you can, maybe on your knees or in a cross-legged position, but we'll get to that later. So otherwise, just find a nice gentle stance. Maybe you close your eyes, start to center yourself, start to center the breath. Maybe draw attention to the body for the first time today. I think this is my first time actually noticing how I feel, and just start to draw a few breaths. Maybe you start to notice a deepening in the breath unconsciously, or you intentionally start to deepen the breath, letting everything in the belly expand. Letting your arms hang heavy and long by your sides, shoulders away from ears. Let's take one more round of breath here. And let something go as you sigh out. Maybe you keep your eyes open. Maybe you keep them closed. Maybe you open them. But start to dip one ear towards one shoulder and then the other. You can draw circles with your chin, or you can just dip side to side. Maybe you look up and down, or maybe you look side to side rather than dipping side to side. Just find what feels good in your neck, starting to open up the shoulders and the cuello, which is Spanish. Noticing how you feel. One more round of breath here. And start to bring it back to center. Again, eyes closed or open. Start to inhale and draw. Now your shoulders up towards your ears and let them back and down. So inhale, draw the shoulders up. Pull them back. Let them go as you exhale. Once more, inhale. And exhale. Now we'll reverse that. Draw the shoulders back and up and forward and down. Inhale, back and up. Exhale, forward and down. Once more, inhale. And exhale. Maybe now you start to swing a little bit. This is a Qigong movement, so you can have your fists closed or have your hands loose, letting them gently tap your body. It's kind of starting to get some blood flow. One more round of breath here. And bring it back to center. And now maybe start to flutter your eyes open if they've been closed. On your next inhale, arms sweep up. I know they're cut out of the camera, I apologize. But link your fingers together and push your palms up to the sky. So again, if you're on your knees, pushing your hips forward, you don't have to be, you can stay standing, but just so you can see my arms a little bit better here. Otherwise, stay standing. One more round of breath. Exhale, side out and lean towards the right. So maybe you're standing and leaning, or maybe you're on your knees, or maybe you're in a seated position. Inhale, bring it back up, and exhale, take it to the other side. If this is too intense, you can also grab your wrist. Don't know if it's any less intense, but it just might be a different grab. Inhale, bring your arms back up. I'm going to back down on my knees so you can see my arms. And now bend your right elbow, grabbing it with the other hand. Pull it back, nice tricep stretch here. One more round of breath, and then we'll lean it over. Bring it back to center. Arms reach up and switch, stretching the other tricep out now. And as you're ready, exhale and lean. Whew. Bring it back to center. In arms, reach up again, big stretch, and interlace your fingers, bring them behind your head. Inhale, open the elbows here. So again, standing or seated. And exhale, maybe draw them in. Inhale, open up, opening from the shoulders, not the lower back. And exhale, draw it in. So you can see different angle here. Inhale, open. And exhale, draw it closed. Start to bring back. And now taking that lateral extension again with the same bind behind your head, leaning towards the right. Bring it up. Exhale, take it to the other side. Letting some of the tension go. Starting to get into the arms. Inhale, lift, extend. And now bring your fingers to your shoulder tips. Whew. Shake out the shoulders. Maybe they're already starting to burn. Taking some circles here with the elbows. Maybe you switch directions. One more round of breath. And now bring it back to center. Lift the elbows. I know it's a little bit of work. And start to twist. So this is a little bit of Qigong. Last moment here. And as you're ready, start to come back to center. Anything else you need to do, stretch it out. And shake it out. Shake your arms forcefully, maybe like you're trying to flick water off your fingers. And big exhale. And now bring your hands behind your back. At your sacrum, interlace your fingers. Start to pull your shoulders back. Chest is open and proud. Inhale, big breath in. And if this is too much, you can grab your forearms and we're going to hinge from the waist, bringing our arms up overhead. So if that's too much, just grab your forearms and then start to hinge from the waist as you exhale and bow it forward. So you can stay here, still trying to draw actively your shoulders and ears away from each other. Or if you have the bind, you can bring your arms up overhead. Again, finding what is accessible for you today, depending on how tired your arms are. Getting a nice blood rush to the head. One more round of breath. And then exhale, release your hands to the mat. Stay in this fold, gentle bend in the knees. It can be really bent or less bent. Just don't lock your knees out here. Maybe you sway around, letting your arms hang heavy on the floor. I kind of feel like I'm like an orangutan or a gorilla when I do this. Just letting it out. If that's a too much pressure in your head, you can also bring your hands right below your knees to kind of level your torso out for this next round. Otherwise, keep your hands on your mat, or you can have a block underneath your hands, and then left hand stays down, right arm extends to the sky. Really trying to draw your shoulder blades open here. Drawing them together, chest nice and lean and open. If this is a lot, you can also just have your hand resting gently on your low back. One more round of breath, and exhale, bring it down and take it to the other side. So options, hand on a block, hand on your knee if that's a lot. You can also just have it on your low back and actively draw your shoulder away and open. Whatever feels better for you. One more round of breath. And exhale, bring it back down, staying here. Again, if that's too much, bring it halfway up. And now remember that cross that you do when you're on a sports team? We're gonna do that. So taking your right arm, crossing it in your left elbow crease, pulling it over, helping, using gravity to help you here. If you wanna add some movement and swaying, you can. One more round of breath, getting in to the outside part of the shoulder. And then shake it out and switch. Great, so standing, if that's too much, you can also just be standing if you don't want to do the forward. This just kind of stretches the arm out in a different way. One more round of breath here. And then release, shake it back, bend your knees generously, place your hands on your mat, and take it back to downward facing dog. So your knees can be bent here, focusing more on the shoulders and the upper body and the arms, right? So not so much worrying about if our legs are straight.
grounding in on all 10 fingers, Adho Mukha Svanasana here, tailbone reaches to the sky. And try not to cave your chest too much, right? So if you look, I'm caving here. Draw it up, but your shoulders are still nice and spread, drawing away from your ears. Invite the shaking if your arms are really, really tired. And now inhale, start to shift your weight slightly forward, not all the way to plank. And then exhale, bring it back. Inhale. And exhale, finding some shoulder rotation here. Inhale. And exhale. Coming back to center, inhale. And now dip your right elbow either way, all the way to the mat or in the air, looking under your left armpit. This is the only part of the work I promise that we'll be doing. Now dip your left elbow, look under your right armpit. Bring it back center and shift all the way forward into a plank. Adjust as you need. And now either drop your hips partly into upward facing dog or Urdhva Mukha Svanasana, or drop them all the way onto the mat. So take a big inhale and exhale here. If you want to find movement, you can shift your hips side to side, looking back. I know this is more of a lower body stretch, but try to focus as well on the arms. And now we're going to take it flat. So if you don't have a lot of room, that's okay. If you need to adjust on your mat, lying all the way down. And if you don't have a lot of room, we're going to do this next part in like a cactus type of arm. But if you do have the room, spread your arms out in a T for this. So either way, taking your right hand on the mat, either in a cactus position or stretched all the way out. And now use your left hand to push yourself to roll on your right hip, just as far as you can go. You can stack your legs. You can try to bend your knee. This will be harder if you're in the cactus position. So if you're in the cactus position, just go as deep as you want. Just rolling your weight onto your right hip, stretching out your right arm, your right chest. Take one more round of breath here. Sigh it out, roll back. And now taking your left arm again, either out as a T or in a cactus, and rolling onto your left hip. So maybe your top leg is bent and really opening. Maybe you're just stacked straight or bent both legs. Again, go where you have mobility and availability. The cactus arm will be a deeper stretch, so you probably won't be able to go as deep. Another option is if you have your arm out in a T, you can bring the other top hand and really open up. But that is for you to play with. We'll only be here for one more round of breath. And now start to roll back onto your stomach. And now bring your hands straight out. So again, if you need to adjust, do that. Now with your palms flat on the mat, start to gently lift it up. Using your low back. Exhale, now if you were too far out, bring your hands a little bit further in. And now really push into your palms to lift your entire torso. And maybe you find a little bit of neck movement here in seal pose. And what we're going to do is we're going to cross our arms underneath each other. So taking your right arm, turn your palm up and start to cross it underneath over towards the left. And now lay your chest back down. If your head reaches the mat, fine. Otherwise you can make like a little pillow. Just trying to use our own body weight here to stretch into the shoulder. Let's do one more round of breath here. And now left hand comes back onto the mat wherever it was, pushing up to come back into seal and switch. Taking your left hand, palm up, over towards the right, lie flat on your shoulder. You want to try to be flat on your hips. I'm a little rolled to one side because of the mic. Do one more round of breath here. And take your right hand, start to push
back into your seal and start to engage your core as you push your hands underneath you. Bring your hips up, bring your knees in slightly, and then walk your hands back out towards their seal position, sinking your chest to the mat to find extended puppy dog pose. Uttana Shishosana. So here it's really easy to just cave into the back. I encourage you to keep your tailbone slightly tucked, trying to find a flat back. If your elbows don't reach the floor, you can have your arms extended, elbows not touching. One more round of breath here with the palms flat, and now turn onto your pinky edge. Maybe now your elbows are on the mat, and readjust. Again, trying to keep the belly in. Let's take one more round of breath and then start to walk it in. Barmanasana, tabletop pose. Maybe shake something out, roll it out. Maybe move through some cows and cats to just shake something and stretch something. One more round of breath here just to move and shake and transition. And then we're going to come into Balasana, child's pose. So if you want, you can bring your knees wider out, sinking your hips back, and then stretch your arms all the way out again. Exhale it out. And now you can stay here, or if you want, I invite you to walk your hands over towards the right and take your left hand and maybe even stack it on top of the right. That'll be more of an intense stretch. So go there just if it feels good. Still making sure you're sitting your hips back. One more round of breath here. And then start to walk it over towards the other side. Again, maybe just staying here, or maybe you stack your right hand on top of your left. Still making sure your hips are sitting back. Again, if anything hurts, kind of come out of it a bit, right? You don't need to push yourself. Coming back to center. And now start to roll it back up again into tabletop pose and coming in to thread the needle. Left hand stays down, right arm opens up. And now weave in underneath and drop your right ear and right shoulder to the mat. Maybe you stay here. Maybe you walk your left hand out if you want to get into the lats. Continuing to breathe. One more round of breath. Big sigh out. Start to come back, hand on the mat, lift it up, and we'll take that to the other side. Right hand on the mat, now left arm extends, and find your thread, the needle on the other side, left shoulder and ear drop. Maybe your right hand stays where it's at, maybe it walks out overhead. One more round of breath here. Wherever your right hand is, bring it back by your head. Push to bring it back to tabletop. Roll anything else out. And now start to bring your knees closer. And we're going to sit on our heels in Vajrasana. If this is too much, you can just sit in a regular seat. You can also sit up like on a blanket or something if your knees hurt. And take a second here, do another little check-in. How do you feel? Maybe you close your eyes. Do you feel your arms are warm, meaning that the blood is coursing through them? One thing I like to do after an arm workout actually is just place my hand on my muscles, like on my biceps and my shoulders, because they're all swollen, right, with the blood. And it's warm and it's just a neat sensation. Maybe too much information. Exhale, side out, start to open up your eyes, arms lift up, nice big stretch. Interlace the fingers. If you grabbed your wrists last time, otherwise grab your wrists. This time grabbing your right wrist in your left hand, extend it over towards the left. So doing the opposite of whatever you did standing earlier. Bring it up, switch your grip.
exhale to get to the other side.
Bring it back up. And now we're going to find eagle arms, which is when we do the cross. If you know your availability doesn't work for that, just cross one arm over the other in like a shoulder hug. So taking your right arm and either crossing it over your left and just hugging yourself here, or if it is available, finding your Garudasana arms. Exhale, take it out, feel the nice stretch in the shoulder blades. And now you can stay here if you want to add movement. Inhale, maybe gaze up a little bit. And exhale, maybe start to tuck it in. Twice more, inhale. And exhale. Inhale. And exhale. And now bring it back to center and switch whatever hand was on top. Now find the other direction. Staying here, or inhale, lift. And exhale, draw. Inhale. And exhale. Last time. Inhale, lift, lift, lift. Exhale, tuck, tuck, tuck. Bring it back center. Arms open up into a T. Oh, feel that stretch release something emotionally, physically. Bring your arms up. And if you know cow face posed arms are not available to you, just find a tricep stretch. So taking our right arm and either finding a nice tricep stretch again, or if you know Gomukhasana arms are in your practice, you can find that bind. If you are trying not to puff your chest out, try to keep it nice and tall, drawing everything in. Let's take one more round of breath here. Let it go and switch. Inhale and find, again, maybe just a tricep stretch, or you find cow face pose arms, if that is available in your body. No judgment if it's not. Everyone's bodies are different. We're all at different places in our journey. And let's take one more round of breath here. Exhale, side out, start to release. Shake it out. Try to let something go. And now, our last thing that we'll do, if you need to adjust on your mat, you can, is going to be coming into rabbit pose. I realize I have a bun on top of my head, so this might be a little hard. But again, if the bind like this does not serve you, grab your elbows or your wrists, and we're going to fold our chest over, coming onto our foreheads and then rolling up onto the crowns of our heads. So you should actually be more exactly where my bun is. Did not think of that. And then otherwise, if you want the bind, you can extend it fully overhead. But if you're doing this, try to be on the crown of your head. Hips lifted into the air. Let's take one more moment here. And exhale, release hands. Come by your ears, pushing it back up. Shake it out. And now tuck your toes, start to lift your knees as you exhale, bringing it back to downward facing dog. Pedal something out, shake something out. Big stretch. And now start to walk your feet in or your hands in, whatever you need to do to bring your feet and your hands together to come into Uttanasana forward fold. And we're going to come into a chair pose, so a little bit of work on the legs. So if you want your feet all the way together, you can do that. Otherwise, keep them hip distance, slightly apart. Start to bend your knees and inhale, sweep your arms up into the sky. Just take a moment here, just a little bit of work. One more round of breath. And now bring your palms together, bring them heart center. Inhale. And exhale, twist towards the right, hooking the outside of your left elbow to the outside of your right knee. And use your knee to create pressure, push into your palms, open your back up. So I know this is a work position, aka like you're actively working your muscles. It's not necessarily easy to maintain, but it's also equally stretching. One more round of breath. Exhale, bring it back center and take it to the other side. Try to smile if this is no good. I shouldn't say no good. If you're struggling, if this is making you sweat, whatever it is, making you shake, invite the sensation, let it teach you something. One more round of breath. And exhale, bring it back center. And release everything to the mat. And now as you're ready, start to walk your feet out. We're going to come into a sitting position. So if you come through Malasana and sit it right down, you can. Otherwise, find your way to a seat. Let your hands rest gently on your knees. Palms can be down or up. Maybe you start to close your eyes. Draw attention to your body, to your breath again. Notice how your arms feel. Hopefully they feel a little more stretched out. Maybe start to slightly bow your chin. Maybe your hands come to your chest in Anjali Mudra or your third eye space. Take a moment. Give thanks for one thing today. Let's give gratitude. I'm actually filming this. I'm living in Barcelona right now in Spain. And I'm filming this on what's called St. George Day, Sant Jordi. And it is basically their version of Valentine's Day, where technically women are given roses and men are given books, but in today's day and age, it's more common to give a rose and a book to both, or at least to women as well. So I think it's a beautiful holiday, a beautiful tradition. So let's give some gratitude in light of the love that is recognized on this day. The light in me loves and recognizes the light in you. Thank you for sharing this practice with me today. Namaste.